Good morning, it's Tuesday, and we're live on the floor of the NYSE to break down today's market action with Jim Cramer. Jim,
let's say, because gotta tell you, you got that phony opening. I always say sell that opening when it's up like that. Let it come in and then start picking, and that's exactly what I think you have to do.
And last night on Mad Money, you talked about yesterday's rally, how that kind of shows that the Chinese know that they're not playing fair when it comes to tariffs.
Yeah, look, I mean, I think that one of the great misinformed stories is that the Chinese target industries. I mean, remember, we produced a giant amount of aluminum not that long ago. We were the world's largest producer. Now we produce very little aluminum. They have 55% share. I used to go over this with Klaus Kleinfeld constantly when he was running. He was the CEO of Alcoa. These are not stuff I make up. I mean, they decided to wipe that industry out. But they, you know, the problem is that's my spin. What they really decided to do is put a lot of people to work there. And we were fine with that because we have a lot of things we want to sell into China. Now, look, it's totally understandable. You want to sell certain products and make a lot of money in the Chinese market, and that's good. But you also have to recognize that you are sacrificing other kinds of jobs, particularly unskilled jobs, which we're always talking about. What do we do with unskilled workers? And so this is what it's a little William Jennings Bryan. When you go read the Cross of Gold speech, what it's about is sacrificing one group to profit for another. And I could argue that it's sacrificing labor for capital. And that's what I would have argued in my days of college.
Well, and in your interview with the Nucor CEO last night, he said that other countries like Europe impose VAT taxes on our goods.
Right. Well, what happens is that Chinese flood the world with steel. We don't buy their steel, but everybody else dumps their steel here. They're always, you know, they're not going to dump the steel in their own market. And so we want to put on, John Ferriolo wants the same tax that everybody puts on so that we're not a dumping ground. And I, look, you may think that everybody should lower their tax. That would be a perfect world. All John wants is the same tax that everybody else has. And I think it makes a lot of sense because we've already lost 350,000 workers from 1990 in steel. And I think there's also a false construct about steel. Now you go to a steel mill as I have, and you will see the vibrance of the town. And what happens when you have a steel mill? Nucor puts its steel mills in towns that basically you and I think are dead, okay? Or you might say that they're opiate towns. Nucor puts their plants there, and then suddenly you have luncheonettes, and then you have tailors, you have cleaners, you have a lot of different services that come up. You have pet grooming, okay? You have Planet Fitness. You have malls that come. These are the things that happen, as if, you know, this is burn down your cities, and go back, read the William Jennings Bryan. Your towns will spring back as if by magic if Nucor puts a plant there.
Huh.
Check
right.
Crawfordville. Check Crawfordville.
All right, Jim, and let's remind everyone, Nucor is a holding of Action Alerts Plus.
Yes, I'm impassioned about it. All the companies that my father repped were wiped out because the Chinese targeted gift wrap, and they could make gift wrap a lot cheaper than we could. Now, it was a longer, it took by boat. You could get a faster turnaround if you used my dad's companies, but the Chinese in the end flooded, and that was really about it. But there was no, we didn't sit there and think, well, you know what, we have to have free trade. We said, okay, so the Chinese unfortunately have targeted my father's industry, and so then my father went to work for the Chinese. But it wasn't like we sat there and talked in some ivory tower. We saw that the Chinese wanted to own that industry. First they wanted to own the stretch band industry, then they wanted to own the ribbon industry, and then they wanted to own the gift wrap industry. And all the mills that were that made gift wrap were, again, like Nucor, they supported a town. And it's not like you think. It's not like what the economists think. It's like, okay, so they wiped out that industry and they made cheaper gift wrap than we could, subsidized by the government. And that's it. And that's, I wish they hadn't targeted my father's industry. My life would have been better.
To your father's credit, he found a way around it.
He decided to work for the Chinese.
Incredible.
And the Chinese were fabulous to him. They were great to the elderly. They really were fabulous to my dad. So, I mean, I'm bittersweet. The Chinese picked up my dad's business, but the people at the mills, they didn't pick up.
All right. We'll certainly keep watching this as well. But let's talk about Domino's. You had Patty Doyle on Mad Money last night.
And the last quarter was soft internationally. And what I thought that was the key takeaway from that interview was that Japan was the weakness in international, and Japan has subsequently been corrected, which makes me feel much better about the quarter. Don't forget, Papa John's, This was a trio of companies that dominated in terms of national chains. Papa John's has really fallen by the wayside. Now, you may think it's taken over, but understand, my restaurant fans might buy it, but understand, they have fallen by the wayside. And I know everyone is very excited about Yum and Pizza Hut because the Pizza Hut numbers are up. But remember, they are selling fewer pizzas. They have closed a lot of stores, closed a lot of underperforming stores. That has left a void that Domino's has moved into. So this is no longer three companies duking it out. It's Domino's pulling ahead of the other two companies. Well, that's important.
They're opening, what, three stores a day?
Yeah,
something crazy?
It's very important that people recognize things have changed in that industry.
And the stock is up 1,500% since Patty Doyle took
over.
Yeah,
and he's retiring. And, you know, just like Inga Tulin's retiring from 3M, another, you know, an Action Alert holding. It's funny because I talked to these guys. I said, you know, how can you retire now? I mean, you're so young. But obviously they immediately say, well, Jim, that's kind of your perspective.
All right. We won't go there.
I love Inga Tulin. I love Patty Doyle. And they're retiring. And I get that.
We have plenty of work to do.
Now they all tell you they're not going anywhere. Domino. By the way, Patty doesn't know what he's going to do when he retires. Inga's going to stay on as executive chairman. Those of us who know these people, my dad repped 3M Ribbon. My dad repped all 3M products until he died. And 3M is really fabulous. My dad represented their game business. Huh. And that was a fabulous business. Inga sent me one of their games recently. And it's very cool.
Really?
Yeah.
All right.
He repped their games.
We're
going to
talk about
business.
3M and our ActionAlertsPlus.com call. So stay tuned for that. Also, Jim, Target, another retailer with a good January.
I think the Target's going to go down because it's up from 55. But that could be an opportunity because I look at the small form stores are really very exciting. Look, it's okay. Stocks go down. They had a big run, 55 to 75. I mean, come on. You expect a little sell-off, don't you? I mean, do you really expect not a sell-off?
And digital comps up 29%.
Numbers were very good. Brian Cornell's doing a good job. People are getting a chance to get in. I know that when a stock's down these days, you say, well, what the heck is wrong? I say, well, okay, that was a good quarter, and I see people taking profits. Gives you a chance to get in if the stock comes in more.
All right, and meanwhile, we have Target earnings tomorrow. Anything you want people
to
watch?
Today.
I mean, Costco, excuse me.
Costco, I think, is now we look at Target and we look at Costco and we wonder whether there won't be a similar level of profit taking. But Costco's not that connected. Costco's connected to a lot of different industries, and I feel very good about Costco. Buy some and then wait to see the quarter in light of the fact that Target's getting hit on what's pretty good numbers.
All right, Jim, a couple of programming notes. You're going to be sitting down with a panel of experts on TheStreet.com tomorrow live at 11 a.m.
Yeah, we've got some good people and we're going to just go around. We're going to just talk. I mean, sometimes I like talking about stocks. I like a room full of people talking about stocks. And that's what we're going to do. And listen in. It's not going to be what do you think of this? What do you think of that? It's going to be people talking stocks. And I really love it.
All right. Tony Dwyer on, Stephen Guilfoyle.
Tony's, this is going to be good. Tony had a really good piece out yesterday. I know my old friend Stephanie Link put me back in touch with Tony. And of course, Sarge has been red hot.
Yep, we can't wait for that. That's tomorrow.
I love talking stocks. It's going to be great.
We can't
wait.
You
got to watch. I mean, really, if you like, look, you obviously like stocks if you're watching. This is what you really want to do. It's the kind of meaty thing that you see when they talk fantasy on ESPN and you're a fantasy player. This is going to be like that for stocks.
All-star panel of experts tomorrow at 11 a.m. And Jim, we're going to keep talking stocks.
Sure.
But you have to join us on ActionAlertsPlus.com.
Yeah, why don't you join? Join the club. We are really full service, believe me.
See you there.